Congratulations. You're about to embark on the international journey of a lifetime. But before taking off, you need to take some important steps to ensure a smooth journey. Whether you're headed for an intensive Spanish course in Costa Rica or a six-month stay in Los Angeles, there are some vital documents to prepare, with none more important than the visa. If your host country requires a visa, then apply immediately. The document could take a few days, but in some cases, it can take as long as 6 weeks. If you have a connecting flight in a third country before arriving at your destination, you may also need to apply for a transit visa for that country. In preparation for your travel, you'll receive some very important documents from EF by post or email. We'll send you an invoice, booking confirmation, and if needed, a formal acceptance letter. When filling out your visa application, include these documents along with personal bank statements. Write clearly on all of your application forms. If you're invited to attend a visa interview, it's important to show that you're a highly motivated student. Dress smartly and remember the details of your course, including when, where, and for how long you'll be studying. You may be asked to explain why you want to learn a language and travel to that country. Be prepared and have a clear explanation of your reasons for studying abroad. Book your travel independently, or we can do it for you. Take advantage of our service, and we'll even arrange your airport transfer. If you book the flights yourself, it's important that you communicate your arrival details to EF 2 weeks before your trip. Signing up for travel and medical insurance is also very important. Erica Travel Insurance is tailor-made travel coverage designed for EF, and it has helped thousands of students. Before you leave, you'll get login access to the MyEF online campus. Here you can connect to your host family and future classmates, learn about your destination, and even start learning online. Take your online placement test as soon as possible so your teachers can place you in the right class and start planning your course. In your MyEF account, you can find written pre-departure information for your school, including the EF emergency telephone number for your destination. A few days before your departure, you can also find your accommodation address and telephone number in MyEF. Print or write down both the emergency telephone number and your accommodation details and carry them with you while traveling. Pack wisely. Many airlines have strict weight and baggage size restrictions. Please also remember that some items may not be permitted on the airplane and through customs. Remember to carry with you your accommodation details and the EF emergency telephone number for your destination. You should also carry some local currency and an international credit card. Bringing a small gift for your host family is a good idea. It will start your stay off with a smile. We suggest that you check in at least 2 hours prior to departure. If you have a connecting flight, make sure that your bags have been checked for the final destination. Keep your luggage receipt until you retrieve your bags on arrival. Do not carry any liquids or sharp items, such as knives and scissors, as you will not be allowed to pass through security with them. If you have a connecting flight, make sure that you arrive at the connecting departure gate at least 30 to 60 minutes before the flight is scheduled to depart, depending on the airport. On arrival, go straight to the immigration office and present your valid passport and visa. You may also be asked to show the course acceptance letter and a bank statement. You may be interviewed by immigration officials. If so, please give clear answers about your stay and your reasons for studying abroad. If you have booked a transfer with us, a driver will greet you in the airport with an EF sign or a sign with your name. If you cannot find the driver, go to the information desk in the arrival hall and ask them to call the EF driver or the EF emergency telephone number that you have with you. When you arrive at your host family's home, try to introduce yourself in the native language. Please and thank you can never be overused. Homestay students staying with local households can expect to be treated like a family member. Many host families are second or third generation immigrants. Just because they may look a bit different from what you expected, they are no less nationals of the country. You'll be placed in a room with another student unless you have paid the single supplement. Please take care of your belongings and be sure that the room is kept clean and tidy. In many countries, it's popular to have pets, such as cats, dogs, and birds. Let the family know if you aren't comfortable around animals, and they will help to accommodate you. Your host family will provide breakfast and dinner from Monday to Friday, and all three meals on the weekends. The time that meals are served and the food itself is probably a bit different from what you're used to. If you have any special dietary requirements, let your host family know and they'll do their best to meet your needs. As a member of the household, you'll be expected to help with small tasks, like clearing the table after meals. You will either have access to the home's laundry facility or can use laundry service shops available in the neighborhood. Many host families are in bed by 10 or 11 p.m. Please be respectful and make as little noise as possible after 10 p.m. If you are staying in an EF residence, the airport transfer will take you straight to your accommodation. EF's international houses are very multicultural, and the language of the school is the connecting link. Students in shared residences improve their conversation range and verbal expressions very quickly while living alongside dozens of other international students. You will share a room with other students unless you've paid for the single room option. You'll be provided with a bed, chair, and bed linens. It's important to keep your room tidy and regularly clean your own laundry. If you study in a big city, expect to take a bus and underground rail service on your daily commute. Smaller towns offer bus services. Arrive for your first day of school at 8:30 a.m. and register with the EF staff. Bring your passport, visa, and all the documents you use to gain your visa. During your first day at EF, you'll have an orientation meeting. In addition to the placement test you took in MyEF, there may be additional language tests to measure your conversation, writing, grammar, and listening skills. You'll have the opportunity to pick up books that you've already purchased and buy any additional books you need. Before you leave school on your first day, you'll receive your full class schedule, which is also available in your MyEF account. You'll have time to take a tour of the city center, where you'll receive practical information that will make your stay enjoyable, fun, and safe. If you're at the intermediate level and have booked a general or intensive course, you can choose from our special interest classes. Popular spin topics include exam preparation, history, art, culture, and sport-focused classes. Spin classes are the perfect opportunity to customize the course based on your needs and interests. The availability of spins varies depending on the school and time of year, with some offered as online classes. EF has certain rules and guidelines that must be respected. Please remember that you are expected to speak the language of the school. EF does not tolerate any form of bullying or intolerance. Smoking is not permitted in any of the school buildings, and EF does not take any responsibility for lost or stolen items, so do not leave your belongings unattended. You must attend all your lessons. 80% attendance is required to maintain a valid study permit and to receive an EF course certificate. Arriving on time to all your lessons is also required. Food and drinks are not permitted in classrooms, and mobile phones should always be turned off during lessons. You should be careful when walking alone at night. It's always better to walk with friends. You should be discreet with your cash and electronic gadgets, such as mobile phones and iPods, in public. Consuming illegal drugs is strictly prohibited. Keep your accommodation address and phone number with you at all times. Always be sensitive to the local culture and be careful not to break the law. Activities are an important part of your course. They give you the opportunity to meet new friends and use your new language in a relaxed and fun environment. EF's activity office can help you plan your free time and book everything from concert tickets to restaurant reservations. EF's activities coordinators arrange a regular schedule of gatherings, day trips, and weekend excursions. You're about to start an amazing voyage abroad. You'll see new cities, learn a new language, experience a different culture, and make connections that can last for years. This is truly a trip you'll never forget. So pack your bags, double-check your travel documents, and get ready to go on the international adventure of a lifetime.